That hotel life, though.
Spending Friday night in an undisclosed location.
I have to work tomorrow. Tomorrow is a Saturday.
I am not about that life. I had big plans, huge.
I had it all planned out. I was just gonna watch Anchorman 2. I was gonna write. I was gonna play some guitar. Maybe write a song about writing. But now I'm here. I gotta get up. In like 8 hours. You know the saying, life gives you lemons. Buy a bottle of vodka and use those lemons as a chaser.
I don't even know. I'm a hot mess. Sat in so much traffic coming down up east north to a certain location that cannot be disclosed for legal and operational safety issues. This is so weird. The lighting makes me look like I'm ill, but I'm not ill. I should brush my hair, but I don't care. There's no one here to stare. I could really use a pair of socks, because it's kind of cold in here.
So this is what Saturday morning looks like. It's cloudy like my soul right now. Never been up this early on a Sunday. Yeah, it's Saturday though.
That life though. It's day two. I'm still down Central North, flying, rode a bike to where I'm at, but for security and safety purposes, they had to move me to a different hotel. People don't like it when you take down drug lords, so they stop selling drugs to three-year-olds. Still need a brush. Yeah, I'm in a different hotel room now. A different hotel completely, a different city. Yeah, it was a good day. I did a lot of counting, somewhere upwards to 5,804. I won't tell you what is that word? Not quantity. The type of count? It could be yards or feet. Or maybe I counted candy laced with drugs. I will tell you though, the drug lord we took down, he was very, very attractive. Like, I was feeling things, like, down there things. He was very nice. He offered us water, some fresh squeezed orange juice. He was very, very thoughtful, which is weird because probably on the news tonight he's going to be very, very mad and say very mean things. Very contradictory to what I witnessed when I was counting marbles or how many hairs are out of place. What am I gonna do in a city all alone on a Saturday night? If I cut myself, I'd cut myself. This only cost me $3.48. That's what the cost of living is in this city. Maybe I'm fucking with you because I can't tell you where I am. Yeah, but if you're really curious as to what I was doing, you could probably Google it. It'll be there. There's already a YouTube video, so you can probably check that out. Not my YouTube. Some weird lady's YouTube who was screaming at somebody I know with a megaphone through a glass window. Yeah, I know. I really need to fix this. But I don't want to because I want you guys to get the gist of what I've been through this weekend. It wasn't even a weekend. I worked 7 days in a row. Well, today's day six, but tomorrow I have to travel back home. That's work. My jaw keeps cracking. Guess who's back? Back again. My friend Bud. This is not gonna be my proudest moment.
Drunk men stagger, drunk men fall. Drunk men swear, and that's not all. Quite often they will urinate outdoors.
Like children curled up, drunk men sleep.
broke bum or rich rake. His dinner be it bread or cake. His beverage be the worst of whiskey, finest wine. Puget stinks, and so it seems the drunkards go to
Green Street. I don't know where that's coming from. Oh.
But there's yet to be a perfectly straight line. Drunks talk strong when drunks are weak. It's easy for a
crushed it.
Straight from the heart.
Oh wait, this hotel is better when it's light out. Turns out I'm at the lake.